God is such a good God, and I'm glad to be here very long, and I'm going to read you the scripture that taken from Proverbs 3 and 11, and I'm going to read it because that's not the scripture I'm going to use. 3 and 11 says, she is more precious than rubies, and all the things thou canst desire are not to be compared unto her. And she's a very precious individual, and I must say that sometimes mother-in-laws and daughter-in-laws don't get along. But when we get together, we have a lot of fun together. Because we are married to two men who are so much alike. They are so much alike. And we just have a lot of fun sometimes talking about those two. So, Sister Valerie, this precious ruby, I'm just here to tell you, the Lord is saying, I am. Those are the words that I have for you today.
Yes.
I am. I'm taking that from Exodus 3, 10 through 14, and the 10th verse says, come now, therefore, and I will send thee unto Pharaoh, that thou mayest bring forth my people, the children of Israel, out of Egypt. And Moses said unto God, who am I that I should go unto Pharaoh, and that I should bring forth the children of Israel out of Egypt? And he said, certainly I will be with thee, and this shall be a token unto thee, that I have sent thee, when thou hast brought forth the people out of Egypt. Ye shall serve God upon this mountain. And Moses said unto God, behold, when I come unto the children of Israel, and shall say unto them, the God of your fathers has sent me unto you. They shall say to me, what is his name? What shall I say unto them? The last verse of the 14th verse says, and God said unto Moses, I am that I am. I am that I am. And he said, thus shall thou say unto the children of Israel, I am has sent me unto you. I am that I am. And I know our first lady is not getting ready to lead anybody out of any city, but sometimes our first lady is leading, especially the young people, unto the Lord. And it doesn't matter if it can be anybody. The precious young lady. But when you look at the scripture, and I'm saying to Sister Valerie that the Lord is saying, I am to you. When God showed up with the marching orders and told Moses, go, I'm sending you to Pharaoh to bring my people out of Egypt. That's found in Exodus 3, 1 through 10. Moses began to play that I'm not good enough card. This is the same thing sometimes we do. The Lord gives us things to do. And we say, not me, Lord. Tell Sister Lollipop to do it. I don't think I can do it. I'm not good enough. Moses even got into a lengthy argument with God, asking him, who am I? You want to send me? Me? Let alone me? Who am I that I should go to Pharaoh and bring the Israelites out of Egypt? I don't feel like I'm really big enough to go to this individual to tell them. It is impossible to explain that mysterious name because our indescribable God is describing his eternal presence to Moses. We have an indescribable God that says, I am that I am. Is healthy sometimes. But if we use excuses to keep God from telling us what to do or telling God no, you know, sometimes we just want to use an excuse. Well, no, it's not me. When we do this, we really insult God because God knows everything. You don't have to tell him your weaknesses. He already knows them. So why are you trying to tell them I can't? God will not ask you to do something that he did not think you could do. So he already same. He's the same today and yesterday.
Yes.
In our world where we have values, morals, and laws that are constantly changing, constantly redoing them, we can find stability and security in our unchanging God. We can find security in our unchanging God if we would only trust Him. The God who appeared to Moses is the same God. Let me go back to that. The God that appeared to Moses is the same God who will live in us today if we would allow Him. That same God is present today. That same God will live in you if you allow Him. Hebrews 13:8 says, God is the same yesterday and today. Because God is stable and trustworthy, we can follow Him. He's trustworthy. You don't have to wonder. You know, sometimes here on earth, some people you don't want to follow, but you can follow God. And not only can you just follow Him, but you can enjoy Him. And you don't have to spend time trying to figure Him out. The Word of God will let you know who He is. You don't have to try to figure it out. It's in the Word of God. Just trust Him. You don't have to be worried. You don't have to be fearful. There are many places in the Bible where it tells us to fear not. So many places it says, fear not. What do you do when you pray and God still has not come through for you? You have prayed and you have prayed and you're wondering about God. You know, when you do that, that's when the enemy begins to talk. See? See? I knew you wasn't going to come through. And if you're not careful, you begin to doubt God.